Hey there, Jackie again. So in cases that we need more precision than what a graduated cylinder can offer us, we actually use what is called a volumetric pipette. With a volumetric pipette, there are two pieces in assembling it. This is the pipette, and this is the pump. In assembling, you need to be very careful. I've heard of cases where some people have done it too hard and the glass broke, and I'm sure that blood is not a reagent part of chemistry. The first step is to hold the pipette close to the end where the pump will be attached. Next, gently touch the pump to the pipette. Don't insert the pipette into the pump. The pump should only touch the pipette with enough force to make a seal. Then, while holding both pieces, submerge the tip of the pipette into the desired liquid. Be sure the tip is below the surface of the liquid, otherwise you will get air bubbles in the pipette. Also, be sure the tip is not touching the bottom of the beaker, otherwise the liquid will flow very slowly into the pipette. Now you're ready to start pumping. As the tip is submerged, slowly turn the dial of the pump so the liquid goes up the pipette. If you do not reach a line by the time the pump has fully extended, you will have to reset the pipette pump. This is done by removing the pump from the pipette and covering the pipette opening with your finger or thumb to prevent the liquid inside the pipette from coming out. Turn the pump upside down and push it into the counter to reset the pump. Then reattach the pump and continue the process until the desired amount of liquid is in the pipette. Once the meniscus is about 3 centimeters above the measurement line in the pipette, quickly remove the pipette and place your finger or thumb on the top. Carefully lift your thumb or finger until the meniscus falls to the line. Then transfer your pipette to the desired container. When the pipette is nearly empty, touch the tip of the pipette to the side of the glassware. This will allow the last drop to leave the pipette. However, there should be a little liquid left in the tip of the pipette. See you in the next video.